Hello everybody. During the last session, we have discussed about various features are uses or an advantage of an integration. Today, we will be discussing about the various methods of integration. With help of these three integration methods, we can easily say data between different programs. There are three methods to make sharing the information between different programs are called as copy paste method, object linking and embedding, then import and export method. Let me see one by one. Copy paste method. It is a very simple. Whenever we need to share the information from one application to another application, so that time, so we can select the data which we need to make safe and copy them and select the program which we need to use the copy data, then paste it. So immediately the data can be shared between these two applications. For example, we have a data in MS Word as a table. Now we require to convert this MS Word table into MS Excel. MS Excel, see, at that time, then you can select the table which is existing in MS Word and copy the table, and again you can select the MS Excel file and paste it. So immediately data will be saved from MS Word applications to MS Excel. This is the simple method by done. By using copy paste method. The second one and a very important method is considered is that object linking and object embedding. Object linking and object embedding are a very powerful method to create an object between those program which we need to sharing data. Using this method, so we can create an object by linking or an embedding. Object linking is a separate, object embedding is a separate. So here you can call this one as OLE, object linking and embedding. So whenever we need to share the information from one application to another application, for updating the information where the source file is updated, so at that time we can use object linking method. It is a very simple to share the information between the two programs or different programs using copy paste method. So only the difference that here in a copy paste method, so we can copy and paste them. There is no link between source and destination. But here we can create a link between source and destination by using paste special method. So when we select paste special method, that time an object is created between those two programs and make them updations where the source file is change, source file make changes. So immediately that action should be taken on sources where we can paste. Object embedding means here also we can use the different programs in a required application by inserting a particular object in applications where we need. For example, for object embedding, Whenever we need to access in spreadsheet in MS Word, so at that time we can directly insert spreadsheet application into the Word document. So at that time we can perform the various actions and perform on the Excel in MS Word also. Like vice versa. So we can insert in MS Word file in MS Excel to create paragraph and perform various actions in MS Word can be done in MS Excel also using embedding, object embedding facility. Object embedding facility. Here some difference is there in between object linking and object embedding. In a sense, in a object linking, data existing between two programs. So only the link is created, a dynamic link is created between those two programs when the source file is updated, when the source is updated. So immediately that action should be taken on where the data is pasted or where the data is destination. In an object embedding, here we can insert in directly a dynamic object of particular program in where we require that there. Here on object embedding, so we can directly insert in the program which we need. For example, we can insert in the paint application in MS Word as well as Word Parent as well as Excel like this. So you can also insert PowerPoint presentation slides on MS Word also. So like this, this method we are calling it an object embedding. Here the program is integrated with the application. So here only the dynamic object is created, link is created between those two programs. Then the third method is export and import method. So with the help of this export and import method, so we can easily convert the data or we can easily insert in the data from one format to another format. Exporting the cells, so when we can send the existing data in an application into other applications, at that time we can take the action called export. Importing the cells, so when we use a data from another program, at that time we can import them. So using other program's data into a present program, that action can be considered as an import. With the help of export and import method, so we can save the information between two programs. For example, for export, MS Access is one of the powerful database applications which is designed by Microsoft Corporation. It is a familiar application of Microsoft Office Suite. MS Access is used to make creating database and database action, performing the various database actions on the data. Here, the data can be stored in the form of tables, queries, forms. If we need to access that data into another application like Excel, MS Excel, we can use. Here the data in the form of table can be converted them into a Excel spreadsheet. By using export method. Just when we are using these important export methods, so that time some criteria can be satisfied by the application. When those criteria or rules and regulations are satisfied by the application, immediately data can be imported as well as exported. Sometimes some rules and regulations cannot be satisfied by the required applications, the times data cannot be saved with those two programs. For example, one more example, when we can export the data into from Excel, just we can click on export to Excel options, immediately the table data is converted into spreadsheet. Because in a spreadsheet, each and every cell or each and every column has a general data types. So that times there is no ask for a column data type or data level types in Excel. Whenever we need to access the Excel data into Excel access tables, that times the access programs can be asked some criteria. Because of to accepting the column data into a particular data type. Those rules, when those rules are satisfied by their MS Excel, at that time only data can be accepted. Otherwise, that a particular data can be rejected. So, these are methods of integration to make sure the information from one application to another application. The next session, so we can discussing these three methods with the help of examples and practical. Thank you.